Hello, welcome to Kraaft It Live. I'm your host, Heather Crafter, and we are going to have a really good time today, I promise. I promise. Yeah, I'm promising as much as I possibly can, I think, but I'm really hoping, you know what I forgot to do, Sylvie? I forgot to check and see if this is going to work for the folks out there, so I really hope it's working and that they'll let us know if it's not, which yeah, they won't be able to.
Are you able to see and hear her?
Yeah, we need you to tell us, please. So it's going to take 30 or 40 seconds to hear that. But anyway, I'm super excited to be back in the Kraaft Shaak actually arting starting today. This is so exciting. I've been working on some things. If you watch the newsletter that I send out on Saturdays, or if you watched Mende Meanderings yesterday, then you saw some of the things that I've been able to do. But not a whole lot of art on my part, but we're good to go now. Look at the arm is usable, and as long as I don't overdo it, I should be pretty good. So I just got a message from Michael. The show has started. Yay. All right. Thank you very much, bud. You know what? I love my friends. You guys are awesome. So thank you all so much for showing up to the live event. Thank you all for commenting and for being here. And you know what? I really just want to get straight to the art. So can I set up my camera while you take care of things, Sylvia?
Absolutely. Looking forward all right. to it. Okay. I want to say hi to our viewers today. We've got a nice house full here. We got Andrew and Michael, Nanette, Kathy, Maria, Jazzy. Jay's joining us. It's been a long time, Jay, since you've been with us. And you must not have to be on the road right now. Maybe it's too cold. Vicky's here. Clemencia is here. Sarah Anamati's here. Jan, Christian. Hi, Christian. Beth Brown's here. Emily, Candy, Carol and Orla. So glad that you guys could join us today. And we get Heather back. Yay! Heather's going to be arting for the first time this year on her own show. So that's excellent. So I'm going to put up today's message. And today's message is kind of apropos for us today. Help me to do my common task today in an uncommon way, filled with the Holy Spirit. Your labor in the Lord is not in vain. 1 Corinthians 15:58. I think that's a very, very good message for us today.
Me too. That totally fit with where things have been, huh?
Yeah.
Totally fit. Did you have any comments you wanted to share, or can we get going? I think I have it set up.
Yeah.
I think the colors look pretty true. And it's not changing, so.
Oh, good. And no line?
No lines. I know. That's what I was worried about. Okay. So what I'm going to start with is I've got my small dilutions art journal just to start with, because I want to show you this part. And then I'm going to set it aside, and I've already done it in the big one, which is the real one that we're working in today. So the reason why I'm working in the big journal today live for you is because I love the larger surface, but this is the book I love to travel with, and I love to do pages ahead of time, like backgrounds, and then take this traveling and then mess in it with limited supplies. So this will be perfect. I'll have a background done, and then I'll get to mess with it later on in you know, when I'm out traveling or something. You know, it's getting warmer. We might get to actually do some day trips soon. I'm kind of excited about that.
Okay, when you say warmer, do you mean like it's 30 degrees?
Yeah, I mean, like, we're getting into 40s soon, I hope.
Oh.
Yeah, I know, can't wait. I tell you what, it was beautiful springtime weather for a couple of days, which melted most of our snow, and then yesterday morning I woke up and there was snow all over the ground. Of course, when I said that to Greg, he got mad and said, it sprinkled. There was no snow everywhere. It just sprinkled. Whatever. Well, I guess we call it a dusting.
If it's covered in white, it's more than a sprinkle.
I know. Of course, it was gone by like 2 o'clock in the afternoon, but still, it's very disappointing. Okay, so what I have here is some tissue paper that is from the lovely company known as Canvas Core Brands, which I'm very honored to be a part of their creative crew. And this is specifically from the Seven Gypsies collection, but I don't remember the name of it, and I don't even have the thing right here handy to tell you, but I'm not really much of a product seller, so you're just going to have to trust me when I tell you this is from Seven Gypsies, and you can get it at Canvas Core Brands website. So, but it's great. It's tissue paper that's been printed. I love the brown color, so that's what we're going to use as our background.
I think it's beautiful.
I know, me too. And I've and it's actually twice the size of what I'm showing here, which I'm not showing you the whole thing, but it's about twice the size. I use the other half on the other journal.
Oh. Now, when you say twice the size, you mean you actually tore the paper in half?
I did. Yeah, oh, I tore it in half. And this right here, this piece that I've got, is probably two times bigger than I need it for this journal, for this small journal. So.
Wow.
Now I'm just putting on some gel medium from Dina Wakely. This is not my favorite gel medium, but I will tell you that it works good for this process if this is something you do regularly, putting gluing paper down to your journal pages, because it's not super sticky. So if you put this down, tissue paper down, and you don't like all those wrinkles, which I usually do, but if you don't, you still have room or time, you know, you can lift it up and put it back down again.
It's like repositional.
Yeah. And I'm trying to find ways to like things that didn't respond or react the way that I wanted them to in the first place. And this is one of those products. I didn't love Dina Wakely's gel medium. I honestly still don't love it, but I'm finding a use for it.
Oh, that's
so
good.
Here's the jar, soft gel, matte medium, and I'm finding a use for it. Now, I am putting on a thinner layer. I wish you could see it, I guess, because it is just like a thin layer of paste. It's not a big, gloopy mess. And this tissue is very thin. It's just like the type of tissue that you would wrap a present in or put in those bags, you know, the gift bags. It's the same stuff. So it's very thin, and if you aren't careful, you will rip it, which may or may not be what you want to do. I don't know.
It just adds to the texture. Well, yeah. You're positioning that. Can I bring up some comments?
Please, please do. Okay. We love comments here.
This is from Jay, and for those of you who are probably new to the community, Jay is our glass etcher, and he does an absolutely fantastic job etching glass. But he actually works on, like, Harley parts and stuff, so he travels around his local area to fairs and stuff. And so he's been on the road quite a bit, but he stopped in today, and he said, "Hey, everyone, I thought I would drop in and say hello." Well, we're glad that you did, Jay.
Yeah, missed your face, Jay. It's always good to see you.
Yeah,
Miss, good to have you. Emily,
right. And then Emily has said, lovely tissue paper. Yes, it is. It's very, very pretty. And then Candy tells us, "I have the same paper, and it's from the collections from The Journey."
There you go.
There you go.
So there you now go. I knew somebody out there would know.
That's right.
All right, so here is this particular journal page. Basically, at this point, it's got to dry. And you can see the wrinkles I've left in it, because that's going to add to texture and whatnot.
Very pretty.
This one's got to dry. Now, I'll just leave it over here to dry. And through the magic of television, I now have one already completed. And again, this is in the larger journal. So it is all dry. And you see how, like I said, it is very temperamental. So if you're not careful, it will rip. But if you don't, you know, you got to be wise about it when you're putting it down. If you don't care about that kind of thing, this is working great. If you do, if this is going to bother you, you might want to find a different gel medium, because this one just, it doesn't work perfectly. And now I'm just going to tear the edges to get that excess off. And I don't care if it comes over like that. I want it to be rough and organic.
Oh, very good. And while you're tearing, I'd like to say hello to the people who have just joined us. Sandra's here. And we have Clarette's here. And Lucy's here.
Yay.
And then Jan, your friend Jan, says, "I need that paper for my ancestry wall."
Oh, I know. This is exactly what you need. It's quite cool. I love it. All right, so I think that's pretty good. I don't know if you can see some of the texture in there. Texture. You could even, if you really wanted more texture, you could actually go in and glue in another layer of these, but we're not going to do that today, but you can. What's great about this is it gives you the visual texture, because you've got all the, what would be stamping you know, I could have just taken stamps and done this, but look at all the different stamps I would have needed to achieve this look. I could have just done it straight onto the journal page and not onto involving tissue at all. But then again, I wouldn't have the wrinkled texture and I wouldn't have that beautiful brown color all done in one step. Quite nice. So I'm walking over to get some gesso.
Okay, while you're doing that, I want to put this comment up because I just love it. I love it when the men comment. And Jay says, the rips and tears just add a uniqueness to the project. Listen to him. Isn't that great? I love that.
I absolutely love that the guys get into this as much as we do. I mean, you know, we've got a couple of guy crafters out there, too. I mean, you look at what Mark Bergeron does. He's an excellent artist. He's doing great stuff with painting and all kinds of fun. So,
yes.
Okay, so now I've got my heavy white gesso because my favorite gesso that I love to do for this particular step, I'm out of. And that's usually the simple, I don't remember the name of the company, but it's Dalla Rowney, I think, is who does that one. But I've got a little bit of water on my brush, and then I'm dipping into the gesso. All I want to do is knock the brown back. I don't want to cover it. So I'm not trying to make a white page. I'm just trying to make it less aged brown, maybe. I don't know.
Weathered.
Sure, we'll go with that.
Okay. You know, the sun bleaches stuff out, so yeah, okay.
Yeah, sure. I really wanted to pick up some of those wrinkles, and I really wanted that brown to sort of fade into the background. That was the purpose of the gesso layer. Notice the difference between the two, and this one's not even dry yet.
Looks good. Actually, I like it better. It's more muted.
Yeah, and it's going to make it easier to put color on because this brown is quite brown, almost a orange color, and that would really, you know, mess with how my colors look when I do add color to this. Now, when it comes to art journaling, sometimes I have like a vision in mind of what I want to do, but today is not one of those days. I just knew that I wanted to play in the art journal. It's been a little while. And I knew that I wanted to use this tissue paper because I just got it and I had to. And then I knew that I wanted to use paint. That's about it. So
that's a pretty good start for a journal.
Yeah. And I have some stencils and stuff we might use. We might not. I don't know.
Okay. And I'd like to put up some more comments if I could, please.
Well, don't even ask. Just put them up there.
Okay. Okay, this one's from Vicky, and this is in response to Jay's, you know, the rips and tears add uniqueness to the project. And she says, except when you are working with glass. That's kind of a true statement there, Vicky. You know, we don't want any rips and tears and broken pieces there. And then this is in reference to the comment you made about the guys, you know, crafting. Michael's saying he doesn't craft, sorry, but just not good at it, but I love the ravioli machine.
And that's not true. He is good at it. His craft is digital videos, so I'm sorry, but he's lying to you guys. Don't let him get away with it. All right, so I've given it a good hit with the heat tool, and I think it's good enough to move forward. Okay, so...
Ooh, here's a neat thing from Rhea.
Good, because I gotta find a sponge, so bring it up.
Okay, all right. Yeah, this is really cool because I was actually looking for somewhere to make a neat glaze. Heather, when you are playing, sometimes try the Faber-Castell clear acrylic glaze with a few drops of your favorite color India ink. Gives you a beautiful, totally clear, transparent glaze. Just something as an alternative to white.
Wow,
that's excellent. Thank you.
Wow, that sounds awesome. So where do you get that? I don't think I've ever had that Faber-Castell glaze she's talking about.
No.
Okay, I've got a round ink blending tool and some sponges. And I've got a stencil And I've got some bubble wrap, big bubble wrap. And I think I'm going to grab another stencil. Let's see. You know, I really like this stencil. I use this one quite often, actually. Maybe too much. I don't know. Does anybody out there have a favorite that they seem to use more and more and more?
I actually use the Harlequin one, too, a lot. I like that a lot.
All right, so I'm moving over just a little bit. Hopefully you can still see everything, but this is going to be my palette over here on my freezer paper. And I'm just putting a little blob of PBO's Dyna. I don't know which one this is. It's either the blue-green or the green-blue. I think it's the green-blue. There is a difference, believe it or not. All right, so I've just loaded it up just a little bit like that, and we're going to go in here.
I think Carol's having some computer problems. She's going, ready to watch my computer play in the snow, going to throw it out the window. Uh-oh.
Uh-oh. That's not good. That's when you know it's really bad. All right. Yep, that's what we want. And we're just going to do that in a few places here.
Oh, that looks good. Nice color combo. Lucy was saying that that she likes the Kaiser Kraft Dolly stencil. She says she can't get enough of it.
Oh, the door. Oh, yeah, that doily that she used. Did you see that on her her art journal cover?
Yeah, that was gorgeous.
I was almost going to do something similar to that today because I loved it so much. But then I thought, no, I'm going to do something a little different. Because we already watched that video. We don't want to watch two of those videos. Although I want something pretty like that on mine. So I think I might do it on the cover of my journal.
And Orla is saying that she likes the way the gesso dried. It calmed that brown down nicely.
Yeah, and it's no longer orangey
right.
either, which is really nice. So.
Almost like a beige color now.
Okay, so now I'm liking this. This is looking good.
Looking good.
All right, I'm thinking this is where sometimes I plan this stuff out, but not today. Today you're seeing it happen how I want to see it happen. I really think I want to go with the brighters.
Yep.
I think I want to go with the brighters. So let's see.
I just want to say this. Orla said that she never thought of using the blending tool for paint. I tell you, Heather's got a million of them.
Oh, that's not my idea, though. I got that from Dina, or not Dina. Diane Rivoli. I got that from her. She's the one who uses it for her paint. You can use it with any paint, not just hers.
Yeah.
And that's now we're using fingers.
Yeah, that's one thing I haven't gotten into. I know a lot of you, like Cece and you and Lucy, you know, like to use your fingers. I've not gotten into that.
Well, I don't know. It just feels so good. I must have really liked finger painting when I was in kindergarten, too, I think.
I love finger painting. I think that paint was cool. It had a total different feel to it. It was like a gel or something.
Yeah, it was. It was like gel.
Yeah.
Oh, look at that. I don't know if you could see it blending there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Happy zone. We've just entered the happy zone.
Rhea says that the reason I don't like doing it is because I have nice nails.
She's exactly right. You spend that's way too much money on your manicure.
Yeah, that's probably it. I don't like to try and get the paint off of them. So that's what we're going with. That's it. That's
yeah, we'll just say that's it. Sure.
That's it.
All right, I like that, but it needs to dry because I don't want it to mix with the next layer. And I wanted it to go horizontally, Now I'm starting to see something as I'm looking up at the screen. I'm seeing something coming out of it.
Cool. Jay's saying, hey, hold on, hold on. He wants to go and get his sunglasses, all these bright colors.
I know. It's kind of cool. It looks like an old newspaper that has some bright new life on it. I'm not sure where I want to go from here.
Oh, it's very pretty.
I'm trying to find some stencils I haven't used in a while. Which, you know, is pretty much everything, considering I haven't done diddly in here in a long, long time, so.
Yeah, you've had a nice 2 months off, lady.
Well, I don't know about it being nice, but yeah, you're right. I have had some time off. Here we go.
Jay says Sylvia just likes playing with a box of peanuts. That's so true.
Jay, oh, that's so funny.
Yeah, he sent me some stuff, and he had the store package it up, and they used this huge box, and they just filled it full of these peanuts. And I want you to know, Jay, I'm still picking peanuts up off my floor.
Exactly.
And that was months ago.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Okay. I think.
You know what those look like to me? The two, not the top part of it, but the two down, they look like butterfly wings. If you turned them, did the two top ones and then turned them upside down and did them again, it looked like you'd have a butterfly.
Oh, cool. This was one of those finds from, what's that place that Sandra loves to go?
Oh, Tuesday mornings.
Yeah, Tuesday mornings. So I was in Arizona. When was that? Back in October, I think, right? And yeah. Jan took me to Tuesday morning because I was so desperate to go to one. And she's like, oh, I think there's one over here. We did. And I found all these stencils for $1.99.
Oh, that is a good buy.
Holy I crap. Know.
Yeah, that's wonderful.
All right, I want this one to be a little bit taller, so I'm going to have to extend this one here.
Claret likes that stencil. She says that's a sweet stencil. It is.
Yeah.
And Sandra's saying, I love Tuesday mornings. I love it.
I know. I told you.
She gets some good buys. Oh, my gosh. I go, and I'm like, huh?
I thought this place was supposed to be cool.
Yeah. I never find anything. They don't have any of the supplies that you guys, grab. And, so I'm always disappointed when I walk out of ours.
All right. So see how I just extended that? I used this part here, and now it looks like one piece. Can you see all that?
Yes, it looks great.
It's kind of light. I realize that, but trust me. Just trust me when I tell you it's good.
Yeah, and Vicky's saying that her store doesn't have much stuff either.
That stinks.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to do a littler one here. And then we're going to do, I think, maybe two over here. But I need more paint. I like the combination of two of colors like that. I think that's good. So we're going to keep that up. And let's make this one a little bit bigger. Yep. Now, as you're watching this, I would love it if you would think of a quote that you think would work for this page, because I don't have one prepared.
Oh my gosh, Sandra's saying that the secret is she's got four of them to choose from. Four!
Four Tuesday morning stores,
yeah.
Really? All right, everybody, let's head to Texas. We'll make a caravan of it.
Wow, Carol's saying that her Tuesday morning is an hour and a half away.
Well, that's still a little closer than the closest one I can find.
Which is what, Arizona?
Arizona. I'm sure there's probably one between here and your guys' place, but why would I stop? Why wouldn't I just keep going? Yeah, right?
Exactly.
Okay, and I'm going to put one more right here.
That extended very well.
Thank you, ma'am. I like the darker, I think, more than the light. The light seems to disappear too much.
Yeah, but you'll do something. You'll outline it. You'll do something to make it pop.
You can bet I will do that. And I might have to do it in After Crafter Party, just so you guys know, because I have no idea what time it is, but I do know that I tend to run out of time.
Yeah, well, you got lots of time right now.
Thank you. She says, just 5 minutes later, she tells me it's time to go. Okay, so because I just can't live without these PBO paints, I'm going to use these two to create my flowers, and then I'm going to use this for the centers. So that should be good, huh?
Right, that'll be great. Nice.
Wow, this is going to be way cool. Look at how bright it is already.
It was really cool. I guess Vicky's is an hour and a half to her Tuesday morning. And Emily says, nope, there are a bunch of Tuesday mornings in Salt Lake, you can stop and visit me.
Actually, that's pretty true. That's only like 5 hours.
Oh, that's a day's worth of driving for me.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, that's cute. I don't know, Mari is just getting it in. She's getting it in. She's going, AKP.
I love it.
So anybody follow her lead, okay? If you're interested in AKP, then, let us know.
Okay, I poured out way too much paint for this, so guess what? Time to find my wipe-off book, huh?
Right.
Wish me luck, because I don't know where it is. Okay.
Claretta is saying, when I come back to Columbus, she says, we're going to go to the Tuesday mornings because there's some great ones here. You got it, babe. We're going to.
Wow. I love it.
I'm all excited.
So we switched from that beautiful page to my loud and obnoxious stuff here.
Yeah, but look how pretty that is. Oh, that brings that stencil out beautiful. Maria's giving you the update on the time, but I'm not going to mention it. So.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Oh, my God.
I cannot see what time it is at all. My clock that I bought from Society 6 is down. It's not up.
Oh, so, okay. You don't mean it's broken. You just mean you haven't put it up where you can see it.
Right, okay.
Okay, we have a quote. Lucy has, I'm going to put this up. Found this quote, and it says, the purest and most thoughtful minds are those which love color the most.
Oh, that's perfect. You better hold on to that because I'm going to need it.
Okay. Well, I got it starred, so we're okay. And everybody's kind of agreeing. By John Ruskin. Okay. I better start that too because we need to give credit where credit's due.
Yeah. We need that part of it. Yeah. Sure. For sure. Okay, cool. There, I've cleaned up all the paint. Those pages are going to stick together, I'm sure of it. Last baby wipe, really?
Uh-oh, not...
Oh, no, I got another package over here. Okay, all right. Hands are dry enough. Okay, now we're going to add some yellow. See if I can do this without it being too... painful. And I don't really mean painful. I mean, as you can see, I like the yellow one. I don't really like that.
You don't like the yellow?
Well, I didn't like it like that.
Oh, okay.
There, now I like it.
Yeah.
Okay. But now it's got to dry. Oh, this is the part I don't like. I don't like the drying part at all because I can't possibly draw on these.
Okay.
Let's work on the quote then.
Okay.
Because the rest of that's dry. So let's work on the quote and then I'll work on doodling if we have time.
Okay.
Do you know what I did with my pens?
It's behind you.
Okay. I'll look behind me then. That's a good idea.
I heard something.
Well, I found one Posca pen, but it doesn't. Are you kidding? Where did they go?
Uh-oh. Andrew took them.
That's sorry. It.
Yeah, sorry,
you Andrew. Are not sorry to Andrew. Don't you even lie to him like that. Seriously, where did they go, Sylvia? It's not like I've been using the darn things. Uh-oh.
Now, if you had watched Keep It Simple Sylvia, she made a holder for all of her pens using.
Using, I'm listening. Keep it up.
Toilet tissues and a box. So.
And dang it. I should have watched that desk.
I know. See?
That's what's sad, though, is that they're all in the bag for the drawing class.
Oh.
That's the sad part, is that they're all put away because of the drawing class. Where is it? Could you maybe talk amongst yourselves while I go find it?
Okay, I'll talk about the drawing class, okay?
Oh, all right.
Okay, over on the website, thecraftshack.com, she has all the information about her drawing classes that she is starting the second week of this month. And they're going to go the second and the fourth week of every month. And she has a total of 18 drawing classes. And they're all going to build on each other. But each one you can purchase separately. And if you're a Society 6 patron, not Society, if you're a patron, then you, depending on your pledge, you can take the classes for free. So if you want to know how you can take them for free, go look at the website and see how you can take them for free. And then,
oh, that was awesome. Are you done talking yet?
Okay. Lucy's all excited about the drawing classes. Yeah, I am too. I'm very excited about
okay,
it.
That cracks me up because that girl, she should be teaching the class. Have you seen amazing. What she can do?
Yeah. That elephant she did is just gorgeous.
Oh, and Cece's face. Twice. She did it twice. One in pen and one in pencil.
Yeah, yeah. And she just did it in pen. She did the pen first.
I know. That's
she
what I'm saying.
She just sits down and sketches in pen. Have you seen my face sketching, people?
Okay, so I think I've caught my breath now. I had to run. Whew, all right, the quote I see.
Okay. Kim's here, too. I want to say hi to Kim.
All right.
Okay. The purest and most thoughtful minds are those which love color the most. So the pure, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yeah, that's what I was just going to do.
9, 10, 11, 12, 13 words.
Oh, okay. All right, here we go.
Going to freehand it in there, huh?
But of course.
Oh, cool. Purest and most thoughtful.
Oops, I already made a mistake.
Oh, you can cover that.
I can fix it.
Yeah. Thoughtful minds.
I wonder who else is holding their breath.
Are those...
Wait.
Oh, okay. Minds. M-I-N-D-S.
She's going to kill me, people. Okay. The purest and most thoughtful minds.
Are those which love. C- color the most? Which love color the most? And that is by John Ruskin, Ruskin. Excellent.
Okay, now I'm going to fatten up some of these letters. So any more comments to bring up?
I was watching you. I think everybody was glued to watching you looking at the comment. Okay. Clarette was saying that she loves that flower making technique. Thanks. Yeah, that was really pretty cool, wasn't it? Just swish some paint around and dot. And there you go. Okay. Then Emily's saying, are pens better stored flat or upright? I think they work better if you store them flat. Upright, depending if you store them where the points are up, then your gravity is going to pull that ink away from the point. If you store them with the point down, I've had them leak all over the place. So I like storing them flat. And your Copic and your Pitt pens and everything should be stored flat. They shouldn't be stored upside, you know, standing up in any direction.
So flat, sideways.
Yes. Sideways. Oh, Clara wants to know, which pen are you using?
This is the Food Ball.
Okay. And then Kim, who just joined us, says, and yes, Lucy's drawing skills are amazing.
I know. That's why it cracks me up that she's excited about taking the drawing class when, hello, she should be teaching it, honestly.
Well, she says, okay, we'll teach together. So, and Emily's saying, diddle on the flowers. And then Claret was saying that that she stalks jet pens. Have you heard of a jet pen?
Jet Pens is a website.
Oh, okay.
Where you can get a lot of things, yeah.
I'll have to check that out. And then Emily says that she uses a bunch. She uses Micron, Sakura, and Uniball are the ones that come to mind right now.
Yeah, I mentioned in Monday Meanderings yesterday, if anybody watched that.
That was very good.
That I had done a test on the ink pens that I had, and I was really trying to find something that was more accessible because, you know, I'm tired of running out of the ink in the pen that I love, like Posca, for example, and then having to wait to order it from Amazon, have it arrive. Meanwhile, I can't do anything without my Posca pen, and I hate that. It drives me nuts. So I wanted to find something that I could go, like, would pens at Walmart work if I got the pen out of the, or even Staples, you know, it doesn't have to be just Walmart, it could be Staples type of a store. And I found a couple that I think work pretty darn good. I think they do. And I showed that in Monday Meandering. So if you haven't seen that yet, you can go, it's the page under the Watch Now tab up at the top of the page on craftshack.com.
So there's a conversation going on about the different types of pens going along with what you're talking about. And Vicky said something that she knows several people who get their pens from Jet Pen. And then here's Beth. She cracks me up. She's saying, quit enabling me, people, all in capital letters.
Yeah, I know. We're going to have people stop watching just because we've cost them so much in purchasing products. But I think what you have to do, at least what I had to do, was I had to buy a few things in order to find out what I didn't like, or listen to people that you trust who have the same sort of art style that you do. Because I've heard some really great things about Micron pens, but I don't have that same experience. Micron pens do not work for me with my mixed media art. So I have ruined, and they're too expensive, in my opinion, to ruin Micron pens. So, oh, I missed the word mines. Where? What the heck, Sylvia?
Oh, I would have seen it. Ah.
Well, you didn't. Okay, anyway. Yeah, I don't know what I was saying, but oh, Micron pens. I bought a set of them. It was like darn near $30 or a little more than that actually. And I ruined two of those pens. And I felt like a big chunk of my heart had been ripped out when I could no longer use them anymore. And I don't want to feel that way about my art supplies. I really don't. I want to pick them up and use them and feel good about using them and not feel like using it was the worst thing I could have ever done. And that was how I felt when I ruined that expensive pen. So.
And then Beth Brown is concurring. She says, you know, that's the best advice. Try a few, read reviews, and you don't have to spend a lot of money to get the right pen for you.
No. Right, right.
And Rhea is saying the same thing. She doesn't like to use the Micron because she had the same type of experience.
You know, now if all you ever did was, you know, tangle on a piece of paper and you never did anything else with them, then Microns are perfect. I mean, they last a long time and they, you know, have a great writing experience, but I'm a mixed media artist, in case you can't tell. It has to write over gesso and tissue paper and paint or else I don't want it. Now, I like this foosball pen because it does all that. And it is permanent. I tested that. It's permanent once it's dry. You do probably need to let it dry. In some cases, you might want to let it dry for at least an hour. Just depends on what you've been writing on. It might not dry the same on a gessoed tissue paper as it would on paint. So you want to make sure it's totally dry before you do anything wet to it. And then it will be fine. However, look at how thick the line is, even just with my single stroke.
Yeah.
That isn't something I always want. So I tend to want a thinner line when I'm doing some doodling and stuff. So that's why I tested out some other pens, because I wanted a thinner line than just the foosball was giving me.
There's a big conversation going on about all the different types of pens, and I'd like to put this one up from Claret. This one, I've never heard of this one before. There is a group of us who go together when we order from Jet Pens. There is a Teranishi pen that we cannot do without. It's waterproof. Have you ever heard of that one, Heather?
I don't think so.
Yeah, I've never heard of that. And then Emily is saying that the Uniball check writing pens are supposed to be very waterproof and cheap.
Yeah, that's the one I fell in love with when I did my test, and I talked about it on Monday Meanderings yesterday. Yep.
So she calls it a check writing pen.
Yeah, that's what I mentioned yesterday, is that it is fade resistant and waterproof because it's a check. It's what do they call that? It's like
fraud proof.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, because you can't get it off the checks the way that they do that. You know what I mean? I don't know. Bad people do bad things. I don't know.
Oh, they can't lift it. Yeah, this is her conversation here. Uniball check writing pens are supposed to be very waterproof and cheap, but I just barely got them, so I haven't had a chance to use them much yet.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. If I had my book right here, I would show you my tests, but oh, it is right here. Do we have time for that? Can I show that?
Yes, we have time.
Because you're ignoring everything. Okay, so here is my test that I did, and I wrote out the name of the pen and the size if it said it, and then I scribbled and doodled with it, and then I did that with all of these pens that I had that I got from the store, are all these ones up here. This one I had to purchase online. All of these I got, the Pitt pen is like a set that I used to sell at the store, the big brush pen and the brush nib on that set, the Posca, and a permanent marker. This was 97 cents for a pack of two at Walmart. So then I sprayed, after everything was dry, I let it sit for an hour, then I sprayed it with water. The only thing that reacted was the Pilot G2.05. Everything else was totally permanent. I couldn't move it. When it was soaking wet, you can see it's like very wrinkly, because I soaked the paper and then I went in and did this. I didn't have to with this one. This one got wet and went but all the rest of these, I did this to try and make sure that they wouldn't move, and they did not.
Oh, very good.
But I love the Uniball Signo 207. That's this one, and that's the check writing approved pen. It was smooth. It wrote on top of everything. I even had a piece of wood with texture paste and other paint and stuff that I was able to write on, but I don't know where that is. I cleaned up. That'll get me every time.
And then Vicky says she likes to use her radiograph pen. She's liking them better and better for doodling.
Cool.
And then Rio is saying that the Uniball vision needle tips are awesome. Do you know what those are? They're called vision. I'll put that up.
I have no clue.
Uniball vision needle tips are awesome. Do you stab
now, are those,
in the eye? Okay. I mean, I don't know.
Yeah. And my biggest point to my test was availability. If it was something I had to order online, I didn't want to test it, honestly. I mean, I did because I had them in here, but I don't really want to keep buying stuff online. I'd rather be able to go. That was the purpose of my test. So I'm really Beth hoping Brown, that I can draw on these before we have to go.
Beth Brown is saying that perhaps we should all get together and invent the perfect mixed media pen. We could be billionaires. I like that idea. And Jay says he uses the Uniball pens for doing his drawings for his engraving layouts.
Yeah. Yeah, they're good pens.
Okay. Oh my God. Michael just cracks me right up. Okay, he's going. Okay. There's a Sean pen and a William pen and a Penn and Teller.
Yeah. That's exactly what we're talking about. Yep. Okay, please be done so I can play. I would really like to play now.
Vicky's saying she loves your handwriting.
Thank you.
And Lucy agrees.
I was born with it. All right. I don't know which way I want to go with this. Now, I could use the football pen on these, but I'm not 100% sure they're dry. As a matter of fact, I just proved to myself that they are not 100% dry. Okay, well, we'll just do like this then. Fine, whatever.
Maria is saying that she gets them at Staples and she can get a set of 8 colors for $13.99.
Oh, that was the other thing that I was excited about was the colors. There were colors available. So heck yeah, I was all about that.
I want to say hi to Linda Kay and to Karen, who just joined us. Thanks for stopping in.
Yeah, really glad to have you guys here. Linda Kay is a new, she's a new crafter community member. She has joined up as a patron. She's really become a big fan.
Well, why not? You do awesome work, lady.
Okay. And it's an awesome Sylvia, I pay you to say stuff like that, and everybody knows, so...
We have the best community ever.
That we do. I will not argue with that.
And Linda Kay's saying, I'm finally checking in. Looks like you've been having fun.
I have. I finally get to play.
That's your Posca pen there, isn't it?
This is the Posca pen, yes.
Yeah.
It has been a long time, and I really, really missed playing around in. I don't even really care if this ends up looking any good.
It's looking really good. I love how you're doing the doodling and you're just, you know, just random, keeping it organic, you know, it's really cool.
Well, I kind of felt like this stencil was really cutesy and I didn't really necessarily want it to go cutesy. So I'm kind of ignoring the swirls that are there. They're going to fade off into the background.
Yeah. And Clarette, she's so cute. Oh, my heart is beating fast with that darling flower.
That's awesome.
And then Lucy saying the flowers look so good. They do. It's like all you right, can see into them. You have a good depth on them the way you put that yellow in the center like that. Looks good.
I think I'm going to have to start paying everybody who comes here now. All right, let's see.
And Jay's just, he's so sweet. He says, even though I'm not a crafter, I learn something new every time I watch.
Well, that's cool.
It is.
Okay.
This page was awesome. Oh my gosh.
I like them. I think they turned out pretty good. Mm-hmm. I did kind of want it to be more subdued, but you know what? It's good. I'm liking it. I like all the visual texture. Let's see, when I temp it like this, you can see it a little better, I think.
You can see the colors a little bit better. Yeah, the other way we were seeing the PBO with the
shine. Too much shimmer. Yeah, the shimmer is kind of yelling back at you, but this way you can
see. But you love the shimmer. That's good.
Oh, yeah, the shimmer makes me very happy. Now, here's a tip I'm going to give you for your art journals. If you experience an art journal page stuck together, this is the tip. Are you ready?
Yes.
Leave your page open to cure for a minimum of 24 hours. If you close this book anytime, even in an hour from now, then these things have not had time to cure. And so they will stick to each other. They will stick to the opposite page. You don't want that to happen. Leave it lie flat. And leave it lie flat and open for a minimum of 24 hours. I've not ever had to go more than 24 hours and you know, experience something bad. It's always worked for me. But I just want to show you pages like this even, okay? This has got a lot on it. For those of you who watched this episode, you know I put a lot on this thing.
Yes,
I let it sit for a full day, and when I came back, I could close it, and nothing sticks. None of my pages have stuck. Look at this. Is two watercolor pages that were glued into the book, and they don't stick. No sticking. Same with him. He had to stay open for 24 hours. He cured fine. No sticking. No sticking. So I'm going to open this page, and I'm going to let it sit just like this on my table for the next 24 hours, and then it won't stick to itself, I promise. I don't have to cover it with wax, although I do have to wash my hand because I just put that all over the place. But whatever. I don't have to cover it with wax or anything. It's going to be fine.
It's beautiful.
So there, I just saved you products, people.
Yeah, she's not enabling you. She saved you. Everybody's saying what a beautiful page it is. And then Kimmy is asking, PBO paints and Dina Wakely too? Yes.
Definitely. Oh, yeah. I love mixing and matching the flat with the shimmer, because take a look at this.
They play nice.
This is why I love it, because I don't know if you can see it here, but those leaves are very flat because that was Dina. And then these PBOs are shimmery because those are Dina, which don't get confused.
Dina, Dina.
Dina Wakely, Dina PBOs. Okay, now look. Mm-hmm. All the richness and everything. And they just, it's so cool because we've got the Dina in the background. And so that's flat. There's no shimmer. And these guys just sort of pop right off of that.
Right. And I do think that that really helps to make them pop and bring them to the foreground, too.
Yep. Yeah. Yep. And then once in a while, you catch a little bit of shimmer from these guys. So
yeah,
it's quite fun.
And I do have to say that, well, you got the page open there. And Candy said this, and I noticed it, too. I think it's adorable. The bottom right flower looks like it's smiling. Isn't he cute? He's got a cute little face, and he's a happy little flower. You made Bob Ross happy. Happy little flower. Happy, happy.
All right. So I'm going to actually sign this, and I'm going to sign it by the happy little flower. How about that? I'm going to sign this one right here. And what I'm going to do is write down here that Lucy gave us the quote.
Oh, that's nice.
This is something I started doing this year, and it was done on a Kraaft It Live March 1st, 2016. I've been writing down so I remember, because when I did the walkthrough of my art journal pages, uh-huh, I was like, now when did I do this one? I'm pretty sure this was a video, I think. So I've written myself notes now.
I think that's a good idea.
And since the quote came from you, Lucy, I'll remember that forever. Thank you so much. So.
Oh, that's Michael's saying, of course, he's got his witticism. Dina Diner, I want dinner. And do you need my address? I think he really likes that one.
Really? Really? Well, yeah. maybe I'll have to make this one a print for Society 6. I don't know. It doesn't really look print worthy, but
pretty.
It is cool.
Yeah. And we've got 5 minutes left. So see, didn't that work out good when I didn't tell you the time?
It did. I didn't feel pressure or anything. That was pretty good. And I was worried that I was taking too long with all of the whatever.
Good. And Lucy's going, I'm in the book. So
that's funny. Okay, since we have time, I think what I'm going to do is edge this because this is bothering me up here. So I'm going to edge it.
Okay. And then anybody else who wants to join AKP, we've got Anamati, Beth Brown, Sandra, Vicky, and Nanette. Just let us know in the comments and we'll get you in when the show is over.
Yep. And for those of you who are brand new, maybe this is your first episode watching, whether you're watching live or recorded, AKP is After Crafter Party, and it's where you just come in and hang out with us. We can have 10 people come and join. So that's 8 others plus me and Sylvia. And then we just sort of hang out here and see what you're working on and answer any questions you might have or whatever. And do you have to have a camera to do this? No. You can hang out with us without a camera. We'll let you. It's allowed. Oh, that makes me happier.
Yeah, something about finished edges. I agree.
It was just bugging me that there were little bits and pieces of white that didn't seem that they belonged. You know what? Maybe it needs splatters. Does it need splatters?
Well, I kind of like splatters. I think splatters are cool. What do you guys think? Let us know. You got 3 minutes.
You got 3 minutes.
you got three minutes to make up your mind. tell us, splatters or not, please. Everything she does for you. So
that's awesome.
I love that. That was from Robin Hood. Everything I do for you.
That was more Bryan Adams is what that was.
Well, she said that to him.
I know.
Yeah. But he did sing the song, so yes. Okay.
I will tell you, this is a whole nother thing, I'm sure, but I'm going to say my first husband and I, that was our dance.
Really?
Yeah, isn't that funny? Thanks for bringing that thought into my head.
I'm sorry about that. I apologize. Holy crap. Okay, Summer's saying a little splatters, not loads. Emily says no splatters on this one. It will cover quote and flower. She won't splatter by the quote.
I was just going to do it up here.
Yeah. Yes.
Actually, I think what I'll do is down here at the bottom. I think that's where I want to do it. So here we go. We're going to do it.
Linda's asking if you could do a quick recap in 2 minutes on what you did here.
Oh, yeah, because I can do anything quickly. Sure. No, I can't, but I will. Hold on.
Okay, she's trying to make up a splatter here. Oh, yes.
Ta-da.
Ta-da.
Can't even hardly tell, but I did it. Okay, recap. Okay, I glued tissue paper to the journal page just like that. Then I put on a light layer of watered down gesso to knock it back, because see how orange it was? That's what it used to look like, and now look at that background. Yeah, then perfect. I did a stencil with some
PBO
paints and my blending tool through that. And then we put the stencil of the leaves on using 2 paints, and then I use my finger to make some flowers. Oh, I forgot the strips back there. I put these strips before I did the flowers and leaves, and that was just the amazing Dina Wakely paints. Yep. And then what else did I do?
It's time.
Oh, I put the flowers on and then I doodled. And the quote came from Lucy. That's that. Did I do it? Was that 2 minutes?
Yeah, you did. You did. You did good. Okay, for AKP, I got Anamati, Beth, Sandra, Vicky, Nanette, and Linda K. So anybody else? Speak now.
Yep. Okay. And for those of you who are watching the recording, I really appreciate you joining, and I appreciate you leaving comments both here in the event or on YouTube. Either way, we appreciate it. We thank you all for joining us for Kraaft It Live. Next week is the beginning of a two-part show. I don't know how to say that properly, but basically we're going to be doing a mixed media piece in two shows. So you don't want to miss next week, because that's the beginning. And then the week after we'll finish it up, so we don't have to worry about the time too much. Hopefully you'll enjoy that. Thanks, everybody. I really appreciate you joining me on my first day back in 2016. So thanks. Have a crafty day.
Bye, everybody.